They're dumping stuff, so I had to leave. Fuck, that would have been a cool place to film. There he goes.
I love horror movies. I want to make a horror movie. But every horror movie needs one thing. A killer. So, I need my killer first. In these woods, well, not in these woods, in this county. Fuck. Start over. They're back. So. Ah, fudge. Thorns. Oh, jeez. Ah. Okay. So, why am I here? In these woods. Because 20 years ago, some guy named Morgan Darrow took an axe and he chopped up a bunch of people. Or so the story goes. It's a little much for me, but every movie needs a villain. And Morgan's the closest thing my town has to a boogeyman. So, Morgan's gonna be my villain. You know, I heard stories about this guy since I was a little kid. He was like the boogeyman. But like, more real because like there's like no records of like an actual boogeyman. When you really think about it. But Morgan Darrow, there's like footage of him and photos. Like I could go to the library and look him up and see his face. You can't look up the boogeyman. You can't look up Santa Claus. But you can look up Morgan Darrow and you can see what he looked like. This is nice. Look at all these vines. It's like Evil Dead type shit. Cool. Horror movie. Why do I want to make it? Well, why do people love horror movies? People like getting scared, and then people like that rush of adrenaline when they see, like, the uber violence. Jason lops someone's head off. Michael stabs a dude 47 times. Freddy makes some pun, and then someone gets ripped in half by a dream spider. It's fun. As long as it's on camera. It's fun. Because the camera is that line between the reality and the fiction of it all. So then what's the difference with me making a movie about Morgan? Morgan! Morgan! I'm making a movie about you. I'm making a scary movie all about you. Is that some fun, Morgan? What if I told you there isn't any Morgan Darrow, and I made that all up for this movie? What would you think then? Lines and muck. This would be good for the movie. I think we should start with an opening kill. My favorite horror movie just thing, like, that's how you should start a horror movie, is with an opening kill. In that one, there's these scientists, and they're, like, going around this mountain, or stuff, and they're testing for, like, radioactive poisons in the water, and then the mutants show up. Oh, and they cut them to pieces. It's awful. You know you're in for something wild when before the credits even start to roll, heads are rolling. Well, I really like that. I'm gonna keep that. That was awesome. I ad-libbed that. Didn't write that. Just ad-libbed that. It's gonna be such a good movie.
It's easy to forget compassion in these kinds of movies. I can get a bit caught up in it myself. But it doesn't work. None of it works if you don't feel for your characters. Because then it's just suffering. You watch awful people die awful deaths.
I mean, it's a beautiful forest. So there's like, there's a lot of stuff I could shoot. You know, my dad used to take me out to these woods when I was really young. And I used to hear stories about how, like, go hunting, and one time, there was this deer in my sights. Like, I had it, it was gonna be a straight shot. I could have taken that thing down, and it was a beautiful buck, too, like. And I just couldn't bear to shoot the thing. Which is weird, you know, because, like, I want to make movies about...
That's not supposed to be in the movie. I know I can get really into it, but sometimes I wonder, like...
I don't know what that was. Out there in the woods. Like, he's not real. I just made him up for the movie. He He's not real. He's not supposed to be real. I just made him up for a movie, right? Maybe it was just...
Please, 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 please